Hey everyone, Mindlesspit here playing The Park. Now, this video is going to be a little longer. I'm planning on making this to be a long play. I'm going to try and get the whole game in one sitting because I've heard it's pretty short. Let's go ahead and give it a go. The Park is a narrative experience best played in a dark room wearing headphones. It deals with subject matter that may be disturbing to some players. During the course of play, The Park may manipulate graphics, audio, control settings, and your sanity. This is perfectly normal and should not be any cause for alarm or psychiatry. Like, you're not going crazy. Don't worry. It's just the game. Like, from what I remember reading about it, it's supposed to be this woman lost her son, so she comes to this park trying to find him. Now, honestly, this is just a guess, but if it turns out her son is dead, I'm going to be pissed. Like, he's been dead the whole time, and she's been in denial. I'm going to be pissed. Mind,
I always return to Atlantic Island Park.
Because that's not original story.
Where's Mr. Bear?
I haven't seen Mr. Bear, Callum.
Wow, that's some high jeans.
Go and ask information.
I wasted jeans. What the?
Attention,
mouse doesn't work.
The park is now closed. Please make your way to the car park at your earliest convenience. Employees, prepare the park for shutdown.
Oh my god, I have to hold it down.
Callum was born the day this place opened. This is his favorite place in the world.
Atlantic Island Park. A tribute to the untamed heart of Solomon Island and the people who use their talents to bring the dream of Nathaniel Winter to life. May this park be a place where joy and laughter are gathered and used to infect all those who follow after. Dedicated to this day, first day of May 1977, James B. Longley. Goddamn. Stop it. There we go. God dang. It would not let me move. Oh, and now the mouse works. What the? Oh, that's the exit, of course. What am I doing? I think it's the exit. No, it's not. Oh. Duh. There's a person there.
Lorraine. Don't blame yourself, Lorraine. People lose things all the time. Take a deep breath and think about the last place you saw your son's teddy bear. Hey, stop! I think your boy just ran into the park. I'll unlock the gates for you.
Seriously, look at those jeans. My god. What year is this game to take place in?
Wait up there for Mommy, Callum.
Catch me, Mommy.
No, that's creepy. Oh, I am not reading that whole thing.
Wait for Mommy, Callum.
Come on, Mommy.
That guy's not creepy at all. It's like an old, perverted Willy Wonka. Nathaniel Winter welcomes you to Atlantic Island Park.
There's something special about the entrance to an amusement park. A line drawn between the real world and the world of whimsy within. On this side, the apathy of our everyday lives. And on the other, anything we might dare to dream. It's no wonder Callum ran back inside. I wouldn't want to leave either.
Attention employees, the park is now closed. Have a safe journey home.
Of course, the kid's moving away.
Mm-hmm.
Oh, now I can run.
What happened here? It's easy to get lost here.
Race wheel, bumper cars, roller coaster. I'm at the side show alley.
Callum?
Oh, it's a toggle. Come back here, you little shit.
Callum! Where did you go?
Isn't that him right there? Okay, who the hell thought that'd be a good idea? Like, kids are gonna want to run into that.
Callum!
Yeah, it looks nice graphically. Uh-oh.
I think this belongs to Callum.
Damn it, you little shit. Come back here.
Callum?
Come on this way.
God, for some reason I just had a flashback to the bunnies, mascots, in Silent Hill 2.
I wonder what this is.
Purchase the land on Solomon Island for a pittance. I might add, whatever old Archie Anderson did to the locals, just the mention of his name had people slamming doors and locking shutters from the moment I arrived on this island. My lawyers had arranged everything in advance, but the realtor still had to come and deliver the keys to me personally. He took it upon himself to offer me another warning. I don't know what you're planning to do with this island, Mr. Winter, but the soil here is bitter of a curse carried from the old country. Old man Henderson, he did terrible dark things, the land remembers, sir. I dismissed him shortly afterwards, mostly amused by his pathetic attempts at warning me off. I have great vision for this place, and the will to see that vision through to the very end. Atlantic Island Park, the name is perfect, and I cannot imagine it be anything else. This is the start of something amazing. Yeah. Clearly.
Don't hide from me, Callum. Callum, come back here right now!
Over here!
Callum, stay where you are! Stop! Callum!
Okay, what's over here?
Callum, stay where you are!
Oh, you little shit.
Come on, Mommy!
I can't really! Until this freaking boat gets here. Yeah, I'm guessing the kid's dead or something. Ride Swan! So this is the rail shooter portion of the game?
Sweetie.
Looks like there's almost something. That's a root, right? Looks like there's something sticking out of the ceiling or hanging from it.
Near a great forest.
Okay, that's not a root.
There lived a poor woodcutter, his wife, and his two children. A boy named Hansel.
Oh, God.
And a girl named Gretel. They were very poor and had very little to bite or sup. What will become of us? The woodcutter asked his wife one night. I tell you what, husband, we will take the children into the thickest part of the forest tomorrow and abandon them there. No, my wife, I cannot do that, said the man. Then we will all four starve, you fool. Hansel and Gretel overheard their parents talking, and Gretel began to weep. Do not fret, Gretel, Hansel said. He crept out of the hut and gathered white stones from the ground to fill his pockets.
And jumped in the river and drowned.
The next morning, woodcutter leads the children into the forest. Before they leave, their mother gives them a slice of bread and warns them that they will get no more food that day. clever Hansel leaves a trail of white stones behind them as they pass into the woods. When their father leaves them, the children wait a while, then follow the trail back to their parents' house.
It's got an achievement. Chad, have a conversation with Chad. That was not a conversation.
Lost in the woods, the children are sent to bed without any supper. Hansel tried to sneak out and collect more white stones, but found that the door was locked. Tomorrow I will take them into the woods myself, the wife told the woodcutter.
Where'd that Chad guy go?
In the morning, their mother gave them a slice of bread and led them deep into the forest once again.
What's going on?
Hansel broke his bread into pieces and left a trail of breadcrumbs to lead them safely home. But hungry-eyed birds snatched up the breadcrumbs and his trail was destroyed. Abandoned by their parents and unable to find the trail home, the children wandered in the forest for 3 days. The children stumbled into a clearing with an exceedingly
strange I'm really scared. Keep looking for Chad.
Its walls were made of gingerbread, and its windows were panes of clear sugar. Hansel, desperately hungry, ran forward and began to nibble on the walls. Nibble, nibble, little mouse. At my house. An old woman emerged from the house, sniffing the air and peering around with cloudy eyes. Oh, you dear children, who brought you here? Just come in and stay with me.
Slowest boat ever.
But Hansel and Gretel stayed back, for the old woman reminded them of their cruel mother. Come, children, don't be afraid. I have something for you. The old woman offered them 2 enormous lollipops. The children took them and began to eat. You see, nothing to fear here. Come inside, the old woman urged, and the children, still licking their sweets, followed.
Yep, because that's what you do. Complete. Whoa. What was that?
Once inside the house, the old woman changed. She stuffed Hansel into a cage.
What's happening?
And put Gretel to work, sweeping and cleaning her hut. Your brother will make a good mouthful, the old witch told Gretel. Once he is fattened up, I shall feast upon him. Time passed, and poor Hansel refused to eat, fearing the day that the witch would eat him. The witch, for her part, grew impatient. Today, I will cook and eat your brother, Gretel. Climb inside and light the oven. But Gretel pretended not to understand. I do not know how. Where is the opening? Fool! The old witch said. The opening is here! And she moved to show Gretel. Seizing her courage, brave Gretel gave the witch a shove, and the old crone tumbled forward into the oven. Gretel slid a large iron bolt over the door to the oven. Gretel freed her brother Hansel, and together they lit a fire beneath the oven. And though she screamed and begged, the children sat by the oven until her screams had stilled, and the witch was cooked.
Moral of the story, if you're going to kill and eat children, don't...
Children can't survive on sweets, they divided up the body of the old witch and ate her.
That's new. Okay, as I was about to say, is that moral of the story is that if you're going to kill and eat children, don't warn them that you're going to kill them. Oh, shit. Hi, Mr. Duck. Yeah, you just... You look away. Nothing to see here. Oh, what? We're back here? I could have just waited. It would have been forever, but still. Creepy ass duck or swan. What? Alright, yeah, no more funny business from you, buddy. Get the hell out of here.
Hansel and Gretel. I used to read it to Callum when the electricity was shut off. Those poor children. The whole world against them. The forest, the birds, the old witch, even their own parents. I used to imagine that Callum and I were the kids in that story. Not mother and son, but brother and sister, hand in hand against the unkind world. We were always hungry, looking for our own house made of candy, looking for the sweetness that could take the pain away. Hunger leads people to desperate, terrible places. Where the tree branches reach like claws.
Yep.
Where are you? Wait for mommy!
Another accident. This place.
Oh god. Despite the constant interruptions to work, Atlantic Island Park will be opening on time. The governor is booked to cut the ribbon, so the only real question is whether we will have any customers. I'm not truly worried. The customers will come out of simple curiosity. I've deduced what was needed from the banned writings of Archie Henderson. It's astonishing to think that resonance of positive emotions can be used to fuel such a process. Henderson himself chose to use negative, and that caused some of the taint that still lingers in this place. I will not make his mistakes. Very soon I will know if this has all been for nothing. Well, someone died here. And someone stabbed a bear for no reason.
Callum!
Mother Duck said quack, 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 quack.
What's happening? What was that? Like a rocks falling.
Callum! Where did you go?
Okay, that's
creepy.
Stay
where you are! Don't hide from me, Callum!
I honestly can't tell where it's coming from.
This old thing used to make the blood run to my head. It'd make me dizzy.
Oh, that's a creepy looking kraken. Salmon report.
The guy just...
Oh god.
Snapped. Those poor kids.
We are waiting for our turn on the ride. Frank, me and the boys, this fellow in the chipmunk suit, is making an ice carving. Was that that one guy? While people took photographs. Lawrence wanted to go over to him, but I've always been a bit wary of those suits. They give me the creeps. It's silly, I know. Anyway, the chipmunk man, he was carving and picking away at the ice. And at first we thought he was making some animal, like a tiger or a lion. But as more and more ice fell away, when you first looked, it was a human, like a human face, smiling out of the block of ice. But the more you looked at it, the more you saw that there was something unnatural, not quite right about the proportions. Something unnatural that made your heart begin to beat just a little bit faster, like you were praying that thing when the ice was a hunter. But then these teenagers walked up and one of them made a face at the carving and said something rude to the guy in the chipmunk suit. And then, well, he went berserk. For a few minutes, it was chaos. Everybody was running away from the guy who had one of the teenagers on the ground, and he was stabbing with the ice pick. And blood was spraying, and people were screaming, and Frank and I had the kids, and we were dragging them away as fast as we could. And the last thing I saw before Frank dragged me away was that the eyeball of one of those poor kids had landed on the ice sculpture, making the horrible creature look more or less alive. Okie dokie, so that was... What's his face? Hold on, one second. That was Chad. Seems like a stand-up guy.
Come out, sweetie.
What trail?
Mommy needs to see you, Callum. Come back.
Frustrated by the fact that the plan seemed incomplete, I know as well as anybody that the rules of the game can be changed with enough money, but no matter how much money talks, it can't conjure up missing plans from thin air. I've tried contacting the organization who sold me these plans, and they are stonewalling me. Every contact that I've had, every meeting place that I've had watched over, are swept bare. I have a sinking feeling that I might have been swindled. We've gone ahead with what we could find in the plans regardless. The harvesting machines, transport mechanisms, etc. I'll probably let Nicholas name them something cute for the day we open the park. They will be rides after all. Harvesters.
Hello?
There's no frickin' trail.
Take a look at this.
I can't get on while it's moving.
Can I stop it?
Where did you go?
Oh, what's this? Seven Polaroid.
Oh, I remember this.
Oh yeah, they look. Me and Callum. She looks a little like Kristen Stewart. They do not look happy. Do I have to slow it down even more? There we go.
Wait for mommy!
Alright, so what's gonna happen here? I'm guessing because she's in such a negative place, every ride she goes on, it's gonna harvest her negative emotions. Like, right now, this isn't looking exactly pleasant. What the hell? That's... Yeah, that's not a good sign at all, is it? Big old toothy guy.
Stop, Callum! Callum? Where'd you go?
Treachery hides in thoughts. Treachery that lashes like a whip and scars our insides. The first time I saw Callum, my thoughts betrayed me. I looked down at this wrinkled, red, bawling thing and I thought,
yeah, boy.
Is that it? We build our world from expectations, and the world that I had built for Callum was no different. He was so real, so there, and so far from my expectations. And they shattered, and as they fell in pieces, that one treacherous thought became a new foundation. All of the love that we shared, all of the warmth and goodness that followed, built on a single, traitorous thought.
Yeah, boy, she didn't love her kid.
Hello?
Oh, God. I thought working in the park for a summer would be a lot of fun, but the end of the season here really drags. There aren't that many tourists around, and so most of the staff spend their days standing around gossiping. And most of that gossip is about Chad. I mean, Steve, see? Even I am starting to call him Chad, and I went to school with the guy. It's that goddamn suit. In the beginning, it was a laugh. Steve, the local lush as Chad... Yeah, I thought there was a B for a second there. As Chad, the chipmunk, child-friendly mascot as at Atlantic Island Park. Lock up your daughters and all that. But the more he wears that suit, the weirder Steve is getting. At first it was little things, like refusing to change out of the suit at work and taking it home with him every day. But then I saw him at Susie's Diner, still wearing it, and it wasn't even a work day. Some of the staff complained, discreetly, to park management about the smell, and I saw him walking and talking with Mr. Winters, the owner, one day. but nothing seems to have changed. The suit still smells like a carcass whenever Steve walks by, and apparently Steve has picked up some new skills since the last time I saw him puking up in a gutter outside the Sequoia station, because he sure as hell can carve a mean ice sculpture. Those shapes he makes in the ice, though, they give me the creeps. Steve came by the booth today, lucky me, and he was just hung around for a while. I couldn't really tell because of the suit, but it seemed like he was just staring at me, sizing me up. I fucking me. Whatever he was doing. Okay. I asked him what he wanted, and he just stood there, not saying anything. Eventually, I called my supervisor, and when he came by, Chad, Steve, wandered off. My supervisor told me to put everything in writing, so here it is. Also, I quit. I don't want to see that chipmunk suit ever again. Lara Hennis. Oh, Jesus.
Callum! Where did you go?
What the shit? What the shit was that? That was not the chipmunk suit. Like, is there a way to get in there?
Callum, tell mommy where you are.
What is it? Yeah, I guess there's not a way in there, is there? Oh, what a loon. There's that Kraken again. Creepy looking thing. Okay. Oh god, bumper cars. This is gonna be...
Constant crashes and 80s music. I guess it floats someone's boat.
This is gonna suck. I can tell. Okay, so what's this? Do I have to, anything to do in here? No. Okay. Can I ride that one? No.
Wait, Callum! Callum!
Oh, here we are. Oh, probably that one in the back with the light on. Examine accident report. Francis Dufresnay. Laborers working on the crane. Brief description of the accident. During the transport of the bumper cars into the arena, one of the straps attaching the load of to the truck came untied, causing a cascade of bumper cars onto Francis, who was standing directing the driver. Francis was crushed by the weight of the cars. Francis was killed. Dexter, the truck's driver, claims to have seen someone on the back of the load undoing the straps. No one else reported seeing that. The sheriff has requested that Dexter provided them with urine samples. Double checking of the straps after transit should be mandatory and drug screening for all drivers. Local laborers are very superstitious and this hasn't helped. Some of them are refusing to return to work until we have someone from the local church walk the park and exercise the bed space. What just happened? What? I don't... Oh, poopy. Callum, was that you, you little shit? Are you trying to hit mommy with bumper cars? Did I ever tell you I never loved you?
You go.
It's a matter of public record
that I am a failure as a mother. Once, when Callum was very small, I left him asleep in the car while I ran an errand. Don't even remember what it was. When I came back, the sheriff was standing next to the car, watching my boy through the window. I didn't like what I saw in his eyes. Judgment. He wrote me the ticket without saying a word. Just the scratch of his pen on the notepad. When he gave it to me, our eyes met. I know what you're going through. My daughter, Helen, she... Just get some help. Help was a bolt of lightning. Help was 1,000 volts surging through my veins. Help is agony. I'd rather die. I wanted to scream. I'd rather you pulled your gun and shot me. But instead my mouth said, yes, Sheriff.
Yep. Okay, postpartum depression. Continually delayed by the incompetence of the builders, the problem is that they are locals and so they believe a lot of the rumors about what old man Henderson used to do here. They grew up on those tales. Every time a bolt comes loose or a wrench goes missing, those fools are crossing themselves against the black magic. Of course, that is why I chose this site over all the other potentials. Solomon Island is a nexus for dark energies, and the thought of all that power just dissipating beneath the earth here, it makes my skin crawl. I called in a few favors back in Brooklyn and got someone at the local academy to see if they had any interesting books about the local history. Turns out they do, and it turns out that old man Henderson has some pretty strong connections to the Brooklyn crowd. Perhaps something he wrote will help me find the piece of the plans that I'm missing. Oh, so like, he was just planning to rebuild the whole thing. I thought he looked creepy. Alright, let's go ride that safe looking thing.
Alan, where did you go?
Is there a baby on it? Sounds like there's a baby on it. What's this?
So they are going to close this place down. Doesn't surprise me.
Inspector's comments. After touring the park, riding the rides, and viewing the startling number of incidents suffered here in the park, it is this inspector's opinion that Atlantic Island Park should be shut down until Nathaniel Winter complies with all safety regulations. While I understand that there is a sensitive political relationship between Mr. Winter and the Senator, I nevertheless suggest that such political considerations be set aside in condemning Atlantic Island Park. The rides, at first glance, appear well constructed and maintained, but the sheer number of incidents in the park during the last few years and during construction lead me to believe that there is something wrong at the base level of construction, and that we should close the park and fully investigate these flaws. To wit, here is a partial list of the fatalities in the park since opening only 2 years ago. Family of three killed when a roller coaster car derailed. 14 separate incidents of broken bones and crushed ribs while riding the Octatron. 3 suicides from the top of the Ferris wheel. Ah, hell. A child seriously injured on the escalator. Over a dozen children reported missing in the House of Horrors since its construction. And 1 report of drowning in the Tunnel of Tales. The sheer volume of incidents means that it is my strongest recommendation that Atlantic Park be closed immediately. Signed, David Woolseth. Okay. Decrease speed. That should be enough. This will be fun. It's already going dark. Uh-oh. Okay. What is gonna happen?
People come into your life for a reason. Dad used to say that before Mom ran off. After that, he mostly just drank. Things were different for Don and I. When we met, I was sweeping the floor at Susie's diner. He came in with some workers, but he didn't try to flirt or cop a feel like the others. He just ordered a coffee and sat there, watching me. When my shift was over, he offered to walk me home. I don't know how to describe that walk. We talked and laughed and eventually kissed. It felt like love. It felt like a fairy tale. I can't tell you if Callum was made that night or one of the ones that followed. But I think it has to be that night. That one perfect night. Don and I moved in together, but then, well, he died. According to the supervisor, his safety harness failed when he was working on the top of the Ferris wheel. Don was there one moment, and then gone. Sometimes people leave your life for no reason. I was 3 months pregnant with Callum. Fairy tale fucking over.
Nothing happened? Chad's gonna be down there when I land. I'm gonna be pissed. Well, startled too. Oh shit. It was the big guy. And he's gone. Okay, moving on.
Where are you, Callum? Stay where you are. Callum, tell mommy where you are. Mommy is coming, Callum.
Now yeah, let's keep going this way. Definitely seem to be getting louder. It's a loose car. Is there a baby in there? Roller coaster ticket. Oh boy. Whoa. Well, that cleared up the path. Okay, that's a little close.
Come back, Callum.
Oh boy.
Please, Callum, tell me where you are.
Touch what?
Mommy is coming, Callum. A lot of people idolize their children. You hear them talking about their kids and just the way they talk, their fucking voices make me want to vomit.
Mother,
my angel likes to read, and little Johnny is so good on the piano. Fuck those people! You give up 9 months of your life carrying them, you traumatize yourself giving birth to them, and then you spend the rest of your life as their slave. Wiping asses, mopping up piss, feeding them, little life-sucking monsters who take and take and take until... we all go insane. Any parent who pretends otherwise is just dishonest. That's called choice supportive bias. I am honest. Callum really grinds my gears, and he owes me everything. Everything. It served the little fuck right if I just abandoned him. Stay where you are!
After that speech, he goes, stay where you are! So worried sounding. Okay, well, I do have a ticket. Where am I now? Roller coaster. Huh. Let's begin near the end. I'm guessing Sideshow Alley and then House of Horrors next. Do I take
this? I always wanted to ride this one. Never got around to do it before.
Because of the shitty little Callum?
Mommy is coming, Callum!
Oh boy. Achievement earned. Ups and downs. Oh shit.
What do you want?
We need to talk about Callum.
What do you mean? What have you done to him?
I? That's insulting. You and your boy are everything that this place doesn't want. The antithesis of what we stand for.
Where is Callum?
Poor child. He tried so hard to do what he was taught. He even left you a trail of breadcrumbs. But the park is just so hungry.
Tell me where my son is.
Oh god, that's his arm.
Which has him now, has both of you. No happy ending here, I'm afraid.
Just leave me alone.
Fool, you always were.
Kid's not here. What's that? Whoa. Miscarriage? Whoa, what does it say? All that you care about? Fuck. Gravity? Not safe. And taste your dreams. Oh, geez. Oh, dang. boy went flying. Okay. I lock off the ride. Thank you. Is there anything in here like a report? It works. The calculations and adjustments worked. The transport and storage mechanisms seem to be flawless. What a wonderful day. If only these people knew what they were fueling. And so what if a few people leave the park at the end of the day feeling dour? So what if the children are more scared than excited on the roller coaster? This could be the doorway to immortality. And such doorways open only to those who have the will to find the key. Okie dokie. Guy's a nutter.
Callum? Callum!
Get the hell out of here.
Come back!
What is that? Oh, a flashlight.
The witch awaits.
That an axe? Can I take the axe?
This isn't a game, Callum!
Hide up. Where do I go now? Oh. So, how do I use a flashlight?
Callum has bruises on his arms, finger marks. Someone has been hurting him. I've asked him, demanded really, to know where he got the marks. But he doesn't want to answer me. Something has scared him into silence. He doesn't dare talk.
You're hurting your own kid.
He's been changing too. Something sinister lurks in the darkness behind his eyes. I catch him staring at me at odd moments. In the night, he tosses and turns and cries out words that I cannot understand. When I try to soothe him, he snaps and bites at my fingers. I think he wants to talk to me. I think he wants to tell me. But they are watching him every minute of every day. They are whispering to him in his sleep, changing him. They are taking my baby away from me. I can't save him. And there will be pain.
She must be bipolar.
But I love him, and in the end, he will understand why. I'm not playing anymore, Callum.
She's gotta be bipolar or something.
I'm scared.
Something's not right with her.
The whole town was shocked by that one. Never found out who did it.
Caught in candy corpse leaves sour taste in park goer's mouth. That was an awful title. Yesterday evening, visitors to Atlantic Island Park were shocked and horrified by the discovery of a dismembered corpse behind the cotton candy stand. According to local authorities, the corpse has yet to be identified. However, they have confirmed the remains appear to be those of a child. Oh boy. The corpse was discovered by a group of teenagers from Innsmouth Academy who noticed a pair of ravens tugging at something just out of sight behind the shack. Nathaniel Winter, the owner of Atlantic Academy Park, has released the following statement. It is a true tragedy when something like this occurs, especially in a place that was designed to bring forth happiness and joy. The staff of Atlantic Island Park offer their condolences to the family and friends of the victim and will cooperate fully with authorities to help bring this case to rest. The Solomon Chronicle will provide daily updates on the story that goes forward.
Callum, where are you?
Don't let the witch put me in the oven.
Oh, God.
I can help you, Callum.
No, you can't.
I'm scared of.
This isn't a game, Callum!
This seems...
All the breadcrumbs.
Are those the breadcrumbs? Oh shit, here it is.
Come back!
Don't let him take me!
Oh boy. This won't end well.
Poor bastard.
He's not dead. Is he? I don't think he's. Oh god! Oh, now I gotta go back there.
Don't let him take me.
You know, I really should have realized he would be standing right behind me. Especially because I tried to- What? But yeah, just take pills that have weren't here a few moments ago.
These are mine.
Oh. I can't read it. 1980s. Are you better off than you were 4 years ago? Reagan 80. No, say no to graffiti. You're a mother. Not safe. But I can't read the thing. It's fuck gravity. Oh, there's fuck gravity. Destroy reality. I can taste your dreams. I can't read that top part of that. Fear the boogeyman. Don't believe anything they tell you. Woo! Freaky. Wait, where'd that room go? Oh god, there he is. What is this? Alright. I'm gonna not go right to him. Okay, I guess I'm gonna have to, don't I? Oh, okay, so they're kind of aligning me. Is corpse still here? Alright, nothing new there. Yep, teddy bears? Yep. Boom! Super slow-mo! Oh, that's unsettling. I hate clowns. Future times! Belly button is the signature of your personal creator. I believe her name was Mama. Every 17th child is a magnet for sinfulness made omniscient by broken fires in the coastal strain. We don't believe that the earth belongs to battered goats and shamrock after birth. Only the truly naked wrens of righteous indignation are severed by war cross cleavages and trust exercise arrhythmia. Bema will come to the island bearing the talisman, and he will shatter the seals that bind the orthodoxy of corruption. Only then will priests shoot sluts, reveal housewives, pontificate, and delayed messiahs make Abels for the rescue of Tangle and Cash. Sweet the temptress who grips the shaft, twists the shaft, absconding with third age tire into fourth age darkness. Oh, fires. Fourth age of darkness. Whilst gods lie writhing on the shattered face of the earth, Gala has sweetness and grace, but her days are numbered, and heavy, flatted hives break before frozen wills and cell graphics, actresses, and pencil and paper pornography. The all-seeing eye will provide decade-long updates on the story going forward. So, like, it felt like there were a bit of truth intersecting with the gibberish. Something about a medallion breaking a seal that will unleash something. Yeah, taking those drugs was a brilliant idea, lady. Whoa. Oh boy. Oh, it's talking. Don't do drugs, kids. Sounds like a Renaissance fair.
Callum! Callum!
The park is a collage of contradictions all of its own. Millions of people die every year in car crashes. And the park has little cars designed specifically to simulate that action. Hear the children scream with joy. In the sideshow alley, you can walk away with 15 cents worth of mass-produced Chinese teddy bears while a grinning carny pockets your hard-earned $5. What secrets lie beneath the sullen waters of the lake? The tears of jilted lovers, the soiled condoms of illicit affairs, the clotted blood of the lonely suicide. And the face of the witch looms over it all. I've always despised her toothy grin and warty nose. I hate that sparkle in her weathered, watchful eyes. I think Callum is waiting for me. Inside.
Carrie Gillian is Satan's whore. So, Missy, this is why I needed the flashlight.
Callum! Callum!
This is the first time they've forced a loading screen on me. That really cut the tension. Oh, God. Chad's gonna be bothering me, isn't he?
Leave me alone!
Done. Atlantic Island Park has closed its gates. A jeering throng of townfolk gathered as we hung the heavy iron padlock on the gates. Small-minded fools, scared of what they don't understand. My machines lie silent and dejected, but I am not beaten. I have sent my wife and son back to Boston, and I have retreated here, to the House of Horrors. I must think. So, yeah. It's been closed the whole time. So, what the hell was that scene where the guy's like, I'll open the gate for you. Whoa, look at those eyes. Okay, those look normal. Okay, I don't... Why is that in a House of Horrors? Fucking weirdo. Oh, that's what I saw in that one... building. There they are again, the cloudy eyes. Okay, where'd that one go? That's not something green. Yep, cloudy eyes. There's a note.
Don't let him take me.
I guess it's not a note. There's a lot of books.
Leave me alone.
Don't touch me.
Anything here? Nope. Oh, jeez. Chad, you're a dick. What? Where is he? Where is he? I see a silhouette. Where is he? Where the fuck is he? Son of a bitch. This is such a dangerous place for an amusement park haunted house. Like, you could fall right off this. Get scared and fall and hurt yourself. What the? What was that? Did he turn? He turned. What is over here? Okay, no, let's check this out first. Yeah? Yeah.
Don't make me look at it.
Look at what?
Show yourself!
There's nothing, what the? Okay, I'm gonna have to come back here, aren't I? Goddamn ears. What is that? That little bit of light at the top there. Yeah, so I saw that one coming. I thought I saw the guy. What the? Is this a Here we go.
Leave me alone!
No. Okay, I was a little discombobulated. I'm sorry. The place is changing around me, isn't it? Incidents, and I cannot dismiss them as random chance. The park works, but something is interfering with its intended function. It's as though the very air in this place is corrupting the power, even as I collect it. A few casualties here and there are acceptable, but when employees go on stabbing rampages, it draws attention. What the hell was that? I'd rather not have the boys in blue either kind investigating this place too closely. It's a shame about Steve. I rather liked him. Okay, what happened to Steve? Who said that? Don't fuck with me, man. Freaky eyes. The thing gonna fall down like freaking chipmunk. What the?
Where is my boy? Show yourself.
That is a really creepy thing.
Don't leave me.
Oh boy. That's safe.
What have you done with him?
What is this?
Given to me!
Oh, you see that? The shadow? Look at that! There's a floating flashlight on the ground there. Whee! That's a minor glitch. Doesn't really distract, I just found it amusing. Okay. Locked. Locked. Is this her home or is this the asylum? Nightmare Circus by Fern Calm. A circus burns to the ground on opening night, killing dozens. The owner is put to death by an enraged mob of townsfolk. Just as he shouts out a curse. Now Raven, a dark-souled wanderer, comes to the ruins at dusk in search of his missing mother. Let the show begin. Huh.
After they let me out, they gave me Callum back and sent me home with a handful of breadcrumbs. Home bit a sweet home. I barely recognized it. Where there had been color and light, there were shadows and regrets. Where there had been warmth, there was a bone-deep coldness that never went away. I tried my hardest to keep the ghosts at bay. Don, watching from the dusty corners while I tried to teach his son to read. My father, coldly assessing me and finding me lacking. I devoted myself to Callum and did the things that they told me. It will get better, they said. Every day will be a little better than the last. I'm in the woods now, lost and afraid. Things never got any better.
That's it. Keep the stip of her lip there. Disconnect notice. After multiple attempts to collect payment, we regret to inform you that your service has been disconnected or will be disconnected shortly. Please do the following. Make the payments listed on your last bill, contact us, not going to be the number, and we can arrange a payment plan so that you can immediately be reconnected. If you believe that this is an error, call us, blah, blah, blah. If you are unable to make payment, please contact your local welfare office to discuss a placement for you and your loved ones. So she's from Maine. So I'm guessing that's what she was talking about. She'd read the story while the power was out. Hunger. A shocking true story. True story of the Donners. Well, that's kind of cruel putting gingerbread man on it. In April 16, 1846, a group of covered wagons began the 2,500-mile journey to California. Just 8 months later, they found themselves stranded in the Sierra Nevada mountains with very little to bite or sup. It was to become one of the greatest tragedies of westward migration that the world has ever seen. Now our panel of Donner experts have uncovered compelling evidence that the families were forced to resort to cannibalism in order to survive the winter, terrible winter. And this never before seen expose read about how the Donner children were forced to eat the brothers and sisters in order to survive. All here in the pages of this shocking true story. And then you put Gingerbread Man on the cover about a book where people have had to eat each other. Oh my god. Oh, that is great. Is that one again? Oh, the wilting. With this novel, Susan Escombe cements her place as one of the most important science fiction writers of a generation. The wilting, a solar flare, has struck the earth. Millions of people are uprooted from their homes. A young meteorologist searches desperately for a way to stop global overheating. And an exotic dancer named Chance O'Hara is the key to saving the world again. Exotic dancer is the key to saving the world? Dynamic, exciting, bombastic, everything we've come to expect from a Scombi novel. Chance O'Hara is back, and you better believe that she's bigger, better, and bolder than ever. Now, when you say bigger, do you mean figuratively or literally, like the bump, bump, bump? Oh, Callum's hat. Callum? Callum? Oh god, a Rubik's Cube. What is this? I love you from Callum.
What have you done with him?
Oh. This looks to be back in the haunted house. What was that? Shopping list. Milk, cheese, bread, butter, corn, potatoes, apples, fish sticks. Remember, I dropped off Callum Electris. Drop off Callum, electricity bill, fix faucet. Well, now. Anything in the fridge? Yes, there is. Of course, it's locked.
Stop!
Nope.
Please, make me see.
Lorraine, I received your letter and I'm quite surprised. You ran off with your father all those years ago, then disappeared off the edge of the map, and then when I finally tracked you down, refused to answer any of my letters. And now you're writing me, asking me for help? I have another family now and another life. Your father was a horrible man, and I regret the years that I wasted with him. I loved you, I truly did, but every year you grew more and more like him. You were his girl, never really mine. Still, I wouldn't have fought for custody if you hadn't run away with him. I would have fought for custody if you hadn't run away from him. It broke my heart, but I needed to go on living. I can't let you back into my life without picking up open old wounds. I'm sorry, Lorraine, but I just can't do it. Maybe one day it'll be easier and I can meet Callum, but not yet. I'm not ready to forgive you. Please don't contact me again, Karen. Wow, your mother signed her letter Karen? Like, your mother or your estranged mother? Denwinch Emergency Services. Miss Mallard, as we agreed in our meeting today, we considered you fully recovered from your illness. This letter is official notification that you are considered sound of mind, body, and may return to work at any time. Please note that you should discontinue any medication that you've been using and dispose of any remaining medicines. If you feel at any time that you are suffering a relapse, then please make contact with your local physician immediately. We wish you continued good health. Sorry. Had a cough.
I'm a horrible mother. Where is he?
And nothing to watch.
Who was that?
Oh god. Okay, I remember this toy. I never actually owned one, but I had a friend that had one, and it was an awful toy. Lorraine seems to be suffering from depression that began early in her pregnancy. Our discussions have made it obvious that these episodes stem from grief of losing her partner, Dawn, who died about 6 months ago. There are also several unresolved issues with her father. After being kept under careful observation, we provided standard treatment for this disorder, including electroconvulsion therapy. The patient responded and made a rapid recovery. Oh, good old 1977 mental health care. Aftercare recommendations, weekly follow-ups, local physician, and mood stabilizers. Lorraine has a newborn son, Callum, who was placed in foster care shortly after birth when Lorraine displayed symptoms of disorientation and depression. It is our judgment that Lorraine is fit to have her son returned to her, and as long as she follows her recommended aftercare routine and continues with her medication, we have faith that she will be an effective caregiver. Lorraine has had her own housing, and her employer, Susie, has said that she is welcome to return to her shifts at the diner. Norma Creed, a local woman, has offered to care for Callum while Lorraine works. It is with this support network in mind that we feel confident releasing Lorraine from this institution. A prescription for Zoloft that can be filled at Flegg's Pharmacy in Kingsmouth. She has been advised to start with a 50 milligram dose and then, based on the advice of her doctor, to increase the medication as needed. Yeah, we can tell where that went. Hold on one second. Didn't know there'd be so much reading in this game. Our inquiry into the estate of Mr. Donald Williams has been completed. We regret to inform you that the primary beneficiaries of his estate, including the life insurance settlement for accidental death, were listed as Rose Williams and Richard Williams of New York State, the deceased's parents. Our agency has made contact with Mr. and Mrs. Williams and explained your situation, especially as regards the birth of Donald's son, Callum. Unfortunately, they were not receptive to our overtures, and they specified that without any legal proof of a biological relationship, they considered you ineligible to receive any of the monies from Donald's estate. They have tasked that we no longer contact them regarding this matter. I understand that this may have a negative impact on your current financial situation, and I hope that I am not being too forward when I enclose the bill for services with the letter. Wow, what a dick. It's like, yeah, you're not going to get any money from them, and I understand you're having money problems. Oh, and by the way, here's my bill. What a dick. Send in a separate letter. Jesus. Hey, I've been in this hall. What is this, PT? Where is he? Oh god, not this again. I don't take him this time. The park, it was a waiting for a child for taking, using joy for baiting, while their mother's mind is breaking. Analgesia when Flegg's Pharmacy. Take two tablets. I can't read that. In the morning, then one tablet whenever you have a episode. Damn, that was hard to read because of the shaking. Lorraine, things aren't right between us at the moment. I know I want to try and explain it. I think it is because I am so far from home and I'm working so hard. Every day working at the park, it gets worse, like a spring inside my mind, winding tighter and tighter and tighter. When we go for drinks after work, it gets a little better. The guys relax and we laugh and we're good people again. I don't want to come home to you without being in my right mind. But when this job is done, we need to get out of this place. We need to go back to the city, where I don't feel like this anymore. I love you, Donald. P.S. I was thinking about names for boys and girls. I like Callum for a boy, and Emma if it's a girl. More pills. That's the same. What's happening?
Please make me see.
That's the same. What is this? See, sir. I can't. Seems to be gibberish now. That's a lot of pill bottles so far. Callum?
Give it to me!
Soul lift prescription. Remember, take the pills, follow up with Dr. Spencer, organize babysitter for Callum. What's in here? Examine wine. Oh, I doubt she was supposed to be taking wine with that stuff. Or drinking wine with that stuff, is what I should say.
One little duck went out one day over the hills and far
I didn't run away, Dad took me. What the? That person on the right wasn't there before. What is that on top of the... Oh, that's the antenna. Okay. Got off a toy. So those were around the 70s. Thank you, William, for the new watch. It's very nice. It has made me happy. It has made me a happy carrot? That's the same. Okay. Oh my god, it is PT. Oh, I thought I saw the guy. Oh boy. Wait. That was different. A chipmunk goes a stab, stab, stabbing, and the eyes jab, jab, jabbing, and all the townies gab, gab, gabbing. Just lie down and let it happen. Basal ganglia win. Yeah. Oh boy. Oh boy. Bloody hat. Wait, what did I say? Where is she? Ryan. I love you from Callum. Yeah, clearly she was out of control. Oh my god. Zoloft, prescription cheese, Zoloft, prescription, da 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 da. Fish sticks, remember, marked pills, tickets to Atlantic Island Park. I'm guessing she took him to the park and killed him. Or we died in a car crash. Well, now. Maybe that was it, that car crash in the beginning I found. I didn't run away, Dad took me. History of Solomon Island. Holy shit. Read notice. Oh crap. Wasn't there something over here? There it is. Made me a happy carrot. Okay. Damn it, PT. A boogeyman goes a walk, walk, walking, sneaking, stealing, a stock, stock, stocking. Is he really a talk, talk, talking? Now is not the time for balking. Cerebral cortex win. I can't even look at the drawing, that thing anymore. Give the teddy bear a black eye. Wait, what is that? Oh, just that. Jesus Christ, where'd they get all the dolls? What is that? See her cry. Say bye-bye. A her lie. See her why. Act her lie. Okay. Why am I examining that? The note's gone. Or the drawing, I should say. Good god, this woman's out of control. Oh, that's Don? My two best friends, Don and Laura. Oh, it is different. The willing sun will strike the earth. Okay. I don't know, that's kind of boring in my opinion. Remember, you are alone. Nobody loves you. Callum is no longer who he was. Yeah, Callum is the one who did all this. Not the crazy lady with the wine and the Zoloft. Oh shit. By the way, yeah, I noticed there's a doll in that oven. Oh, fuck me. Fuck you. No. Come on, open the... Okay. What is that noise? I thought I took it.
What have you done with them?
It's locked. Yep. Oh god. As we agreed in our meeting today, we consider you to be batshit fucking insane. Let's be clear, you are in no way sound of mind and body, and you are a danger to everybody around you. Please note that your only escape from this should be drugs. A shitload of them. Smoking, snorting, oral, intravenous. Take them any way you can and as often as you can. That shit can only make your life better. In case there was any doubt, you are suffering a relapse and nobody really cares. Nobody can help you now. Don't fuck this up. Dr. Spock, Dunwich Medica. Yeah, that's not new. Made me a happy carrot. I'm a happy carrot. Okay, so what's happening now? Okay. I need you to focus on what we are discussing. The chipmunk killer, Steve Gardner. He was locked away for what he did to those kids. Nathaniel Winter hasn't been seen in years, but he is nowhere near Atlantic Island Park. We've established this. You know this. What's going on with the heightening music? The woodcutter is dead, the witch always wins, the woodcutter is dead, the witch always wins, that's all it says. The melting, the sun will be devoured, all the cattle will be enslaved, the shadow lies on your future, our domination. If you listen, Lorraine, you are the key to damning the world. We are irrepressible. Okay, the walls are melt. The walls are bleeding. The walls are fucking bleeding. Okay. Moving on. My two best friends, Don and Laura. Oh shit. Don't forget Don, Dad, Callum, not him. Oh god, what's gonna... I don't wanna walk under the bodies. You know what's gonna happen. I know what's gonna happen. I don't wanna walk under the bodies. Oh, they didn't move. Okay.
Who was that?
Yeah, that's nothing there. Oh, shit. You will watch me rot. That hellhole. Nope. Still nope. Okay, something new. So we're done with the PT section. Okay.
Stories are told again and again, and from their shape we build our understanding of the world. Two children are led into the woods. They are lost for a time, but then are captured by an old witch. A child goes missing in Atlantic Island Park. He wanders lost for a time before finding his way into the mouth of an old witch. In the oldest version of the story, the mother and the witch were the same person.
I never wanted to be the witch. But I am, aren't I?
Kids broke in today. It's been so long since I've heard laughter. So very long. I took one of them. I couldn't help myself. It was fast. The others didn't notice. I liked hearing him laugh. This boy from the academy. I put him on a slab. I tickled him until he couldn't breathe. My machines came to life, whirring in time to his gasps and shriek. I think this is delightful. The change wrought in me by the machines is not yet complete. There must be other children I can lay on my slab. Oh boy. I think I'm farther in. Really far in. Eyes of Art Sparkle. Postpartum depression? Okay, what's gonna happen? Hansel and Gretel and... Oh, it is Hansel and Gretel, okay. What? How does picking up a book open a secret compartment? That's fucking weird. Oh.
Callum. Callum!
Oh.
Callum.
Missing a shoe. Oh shit. Cthulhu shirt! Now he's gone, right? Slab is empty. Maybe not.
Lorraine. Don't blame yourself, Lorraine. People lose things all the time.
What the? What the shit is the jar for? Wasn't that the guy in the beginning?
Take a deep breath and think about the last place you saw your son.
In my heart and mind, I always return to Atlantic Island Park.
Hmm. Huh. Okay, let's see what if there's anything extra now. Probably not. No. Okay, well, that was the park. Definitely a good story. I kind of confused though. I was like, so she did kill him and now she's acting like she lost him to the police? That was going on? Okay. Well, I really did enjoy this game. And so if you'd like to try it yourself, there'll be a store page link below. If you enjoyed watching me play this, Please like, subscribe, share. All that razzmatazz. Thanks for watching.